as you've heard, Microsoft and Oracle are expanding our partnership to support mutual customers that want to operate highly secure, mission-critical Oracle database workloads in Azure. We're going to tell you more about that. I'm Corey Sanders, Corporate Vice President at Microsoft Azure, and I'm here with a good friend and colleague, Karan Batta, Senior Vice President of Product Management at Oracle.
Thanks, Corey. Thanks for having me here. Leading organizations in every industry have long relied upon Oracle Database and Oracle Exadata and technologies like Oracle RAC to power mission-critical applications. These applications require the highest levels of availability, performance, security, and scale. As organizations move these applications to the cloud, they need to preserve the highest levels of service. With this partnership, you can now run Oracle Database workloads in Azure using Oracle Exadata and autonomous database services, just like you would on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. With the Oracle Database at Azure, migration from on-premises database and Exadata is extremely straightforward. You can now run these workloads where you choose with the full power of Oracle Database and Exadata using an integrated and jointly supported solution.
That's correct, Karan. And it starts with bringing powerful Oracle Exadata infrastructure into Azure data centers with everything in one secure data center, in one secure virtual network. You'll get a sense of how easy it is to purchase and deploy, and you'll be able to see that you can bring everything together in that one secure environment incredibly seamlessly, which ultimately makes it easier to innovate with all the richness of Azure. We'll share one example you can enable when you combine your Exadata data with innovative Azure cloud services. Let's take a look at how this might work. Let me introduce you to Woodgrow Financial, a fictitious multinational banking and wealth management firm. The company has millions of customers across five countries and runs its mission-critical processing and analytical workloads with Oracle Exadata on-premises. These workloads typically process millions of transactions and petabytes of data daily, with significant spikes in demand.
Woodgrow has dozens of custom applications which require complex integrations with custom pipelines, real-time ingestion of market data feeds and statistical models using automated reasoning that serve their organization's day-to-day operations in multiple markets. These applications form the backbone of their business and requires a full array of Oracle database capabilities to power them and ensure their availability. As part of its cloud transformation journey, the organization wants to migrate mission-critical Oracle workloads to Azure while maintaining performance, availability, security, and compliance.
Meanwhile, Woodgrow considers the customer experience a key differentiator. Every touch point counts. Call centers, mobile apps, special promotions, advisory services, and of course, brick and mortar operations. The bank wants to convert their massive customer data into immediate insights to get more share of wallet from top customers, reduce unnecessary churn, and capitalize on new opportunities. Let's go ahead and see what that migration journey to Azure might look like. First, Woodgrow migrates their application tier to a combination of Azure VMs and Azure Kubernetes services. Then they start the database tier migration. Let's see how. First, they purchase Oracle Database at Azure through the Azure Marketplace. They can use their existing Microsoft Azure consumption commitments. They click through plans and pricing, usage information, and click purchase. Select the name. And after they review the offer, they can complete the purchase. Now let's see how Woodgrow deploys the Oracle Exadata infrastructure and Oracle Database services. To do that, we navigate to Oracle Database at Azure. And Woodgrow can see the Oracle Database service in the portal like its other native Azure services. Now let's provision the infrastructure. First, we give it a name. Then, the number of database servers and storage servers. We choose rolling maintenance. And then we consent and create. Now, because provisioning can take a little bit of time, what we're going to do is we're going to look at Exadata infrastructure that I created earlier. This infrastructure consists of three database servers and four storage servers. From here, now, of course, all you need to do is deploy the VM clusters and deploy the Oracle databases on those clusters. And that's it for provisioning. Because Woodgrove is deploying the databases in proximity to the application tier, this ensures low latency and enhances security. Important to note, this is in the same building, the same data center, as the Azure services to which it's connecting.
Thanks, Corey. Now, what's happening in behind the scenes is that we're deploying Oracle Exadata infrastructure managed by Oracle inside of Azure data centers. Exadata combines a scale-out architecture for Oracle Database with database-aware system software and built-in automation to accelerate all database workloads. Oracle Real Application Clusters, or RAC, distributes workloads across database servers for extreme throughput on high availability. And data is distributed across storage servers to increase throughput and resiliency. Exadata includes dozens of optimizations, including Smart Scan, that automatically breaks up analytics queries and processes them in parallel at a storage level. It also reduces transaction processing latency by directly reading data from and writing it to storage servers, letting SQL read IOs complete in less than 19 microseconds. Exadata allows customers to dynamically scale database service consumption and pay only for what they use, while Autonomous Database fully automated scaling and other management tasks. Exadata compute and storage infrastructure can be scaled independently, so customers demanding the most extreme database workloads can benefit from up to tens of millions of IOPS, terabytes per second of scan throughput, and petabytes of capacity. By running Oracle Database at Azure with Exadata infrastructure, Azure customers will now have the most powerful Oracle Database side by side next to their key Azure services. Back to Woodgrove Financial. Now that they're deployed, they can now ready to migrate apps and data. Migrating from Oracle Database or Oracle Database on Exadata is very straightforward. We've proven strategies and services to help you perform non-disrupted and validated migrations. We also have migration technologies for nearly any scenario, including automated solutions like zero downtime migration. Exadata offers the same functionality on premises and in the cloud, so you don't have to redesign or re-architect your applications. Once you've migrated, Oracle manages the database infrastructure so you don't have to. We handle all the maintenance, patches, updates transparently. If you're using Autonomous Database, we handle the database management chores as well.
Thank you, Karan. Very, very exciting technology. But now back to Woodgrove Financial. Woodgrove is now ready to bring together the power of Oracle Database that you just heard from Karan and the Microsoft Cloud. As you may recall, they want to better understand the factors that shape the experiences of its customers. Woodgrove Financial creates a reporting system powered by the integration of Microsoft Fabric and Oracle Exadata Database at Azure. This is to help different areas of the bank understand their impact on customer satisfaction, typically crystallized in the bank's Net Promoter Score based on customer responses to surveys. Let's take a look. Here's a dashboard that has caught the attention of a Woodgrove executive. It includes data about revenue and customer satisfaction scores in North America. Woodgrove wants to understand if the customer satisfaction score is connected to the local experience, like the branch where the account was opened. Let's see how the branches with the highest customer satisfaction scores are performing. Based on the summary, you can see the trends are going up. Now let's check branches with the lowest customer sat ratings. Trends are going down. So Woodgrove wants to know, what do branches with higher NPS have in common? With the new Microsoft Power BI and built-in Copilot experience, Woodgrove can get to some answers. We're going to use the Copilot prompt. What causes NPS scores to go up? And click go. Well, behind the scenes is an analysis that includes millions of data points. Here's the page that Woodgrove sees. It delivers a set of key influential characteristics that appear to cause the Net Promoter Scores to go up. For example, closing the branch at 6 p.m. versus 4 p.m. leads to an increase in 32 points. In the same way, keeping branches open on Saturday leads to an increase of 19 points. The list goes on, and the number of advisors at the branch also matters, and so on and so on. So how do we turn this into action? It's another prompt for the Copilot. Let's ask about branches with the lowest NPS. We'll ask Copilot to create another report. And just like that, Woodgrove has a view of its North American branches and NPS scores with the factors that influence NPS.
As we just showed, organizations that run Exadata, Autonomous, and Oracle Database workloads on Azure are able to migrate and modernize many more critical applications in the cloud. They can take advantage of powerful Azure services to turn massive amounts of data into actionable insight. This enables faster decision-making to meet business goals, including the quest to improve customer experience. If you want to know more, go ahead and connect with your Oracle and Microsoft account reps.
There is so much more that you can do with your data in Azure. Create and deploy apps faster, automate routine processes with low-code tools, and so much more. Thank you so much for having us.